everyone. Welcome to my next and final reaction to the fall of the House of Usher. This is episode 8, The Rape. In 1980, Roderick and Madeline seize a chance to cement their fortune for a price. Decades later, the remaining Ushers reckon with the consequences. This is the ultimate episode. We're going to find out everything in this. Hopefully find out who Verna is, although I think we've pretty much established she's pretty much just the angel of death. The fact that she can be anywhere, everywhere, all at once. She does seem to like Maury, though, because she warned Maury to get out of Perry's party. And then she said, you had to bring her home and you had to use the pliers or something. So it's like she was going to do something to Frederick, like she was saying, like, just let him have a heart attack, blame the cocaine or something. But then seeing how he treated Maury made her do something else. I hope Juno survives. I like her. Yeah, it says the remaining Ushers, which obviously would be Maury, Lenore, Juno, any others who might be out there. With this being a limited series, what do you call this? Do you call this a season finale or series finale? Because I don't think Mike Flanagan really does follow-ups, although Blind Manor might have been. I think it was separate from Hill House. I don't really think it was like a sequel so much. I don't know. I haven't seen it as of this recording. So I don't think it was a sequel. I think it was simply a standalone. So it seems like these are limited series. There's not really ever any intention of having a follow-up or a sequel. So I guess you would call this a series finale and not season finale. But at the same time, season finale seems better. I don't know. When I label this, whenever you're watching this on YouTube and Rumble, I'll probably label it series finale because, again, this is probably going to be it. But as of what I saw yesterday on Instagram at this time, October of 2023, as of recording, this was number one on Netflix. Yeah, I think it said it was like through the 22nd or so, 26, maybe the 19th through 26, something like that. So, yeah, obviously it's been doing incredibly well. Mike Flanagan has another hit. I think Mike Flanagan usually always has hits on his hands, but this one I think is especially just because there's one, a lot of Poe people out there, and I think the way they just marketed it, you know, because I mean, even though I was already following it on Instagram, come especially the last month here in September and October, they really were marketing the shit out of this thing. So, and it seems like some people love it. I've seen some people who talk about that they've already seen it twice and whatnot. And I'm like, well, that's great, you know? I'm really happy for Mike Flanagan and everyone involved in this to have a hit, this hit on their hands. And at the time recording, they had just announced that Mike Flanagan was going to be working on another movie, a Stephen King one, Life of Chuck, I believe it was called. And he's reuniting with a former Whovian, who is Karen Gillan, who of course played Amy Pond. They had worked together back in 2013 on Oculus. So it's nice that they are going to reunite. I've noticed he's kind of like Tim Burton in the fact that he works with a lot of the same actors, and I believe I mentioned this before, because Katie Siegel, Zach Guilford, Samantha Sloyan, I think that's her name, and a couple others, I recognized them from Midnight Mass. Katie Siegel, I know, was in that movie Hush. And I think some of them were in, like, Hill House and Bly Manor and stuff like that. So it's nice that they want to work with him again. I always think that that's a good sign. Again, kind of like Tim Burton, how Tim Burton and Johnny Depp always work together. But I think it's a good sign when a director gets more, you know, gets people who want to work with them multiple times. Anyways, let us get started with the series finale, the final episode of The Fall of the House of Usher, The Raven, aka Verna. Raven calling. Yeah, you're not dead yet.
84,000 people just last year. Just in the U.S. That's just a guess. It's impossible to know the real numbers. There's only a few more transactions left.
Leave Lenore alone.
And listen. There's the opening bell. Rung today by a representative from Fortunato Incorporated.
I'd like to make another statement.
Unfortunately, she just signed her death certificate.
I'm proud of her.
Did you tell him yet?
I am pretty sure you will.
No, so they kind of focus on the phone.
She is the best of us.
It's not her texting.
You won't answer her texts. Of all of my children, I most like Tamerlane.
They were young. They only knew appetite, and here you sit. Come with me. Gorge yourselves. How could I compete with that? Mm. You didn't feed them, though, did you?
No.
You starved them.
For more.
Less and less of them came back each time until one day they were empty. They were siphoned. I thought you were...
Yep, she did.
What did you do?
Yep, here's the justification. Okay.
Powerful man.
I wondered if maybe she'd put something in his drink.
Stop. Okay. 3 million. Dollars. Fucking each.
3 million each?
To start.
In 1980, that would have been a lot.
And then you disappeared. You ran off. To a beach somewhere without extradition. The company's empty. I'll spend half of the existing brass. They're all tainted goods.
All named in the file, too.
The husband almost put their head through bad news. Not if the feds decide to tighten it again. Unless, what if there was a candidate who already escaped the hangman once?
Maybe someone the board's already heard a lot about.
Someone, even Rufus Griswold, admitted was a cut above, bulletproof, trustworthy beyond it.
Given my celebrity status right now, I'll be on the fast track.
Especially after you talked him up so damn much.
Damn.
And now, like you said, you can make all the noise you want, and no one's due back at work for a week, so happy New Year. Oh. Wait.
Yeah. When they wander by a random wall.
Yep. That candle lasts you about an hour or so, then I'm afraid you're in the dark.
You're gonna say it costs what, our souls or whatever?
No such thing. For one, and even if there was, you already sold them tonight, one brick at a time. No, nothing so silly as that. It won't even go on your tab. Mm-hmm. What if I said you get all that, the whole thing. And the price is deferred. Let the next generation foot the bill. So that's the deal. You get the whole world. And when you're done, at the end of it all, just before you would have died, Roderick, just before you would have died anyway, your bloodline dies with you.
Mm-hmm.
You too.
Your part.
Rub it off. We were drunk. Maybe we were stoned. You remembered it differently. It was a fully a delusion shared by two. And then we never talked about it again.
Until.
They never found Chris. The cops never came. The board voted me in. And the work began. Ligadome began. And over the years, it was just a weird dream. Nothing more.
Kim was looking for this woman. You said they found her?
Yeah.
Where was she?
Money and what you really need? You could solve it all with some despair.
It is a good point.
But you were the first to do it. The Transglobe Expedition. That man.
Wait, what are you talking about? Lenore Usher isn't dead.
She.
That's not possible, Patrick. That's not. She's been texting you all night.
No, she hasn't.
Madeline had this project. Sentient AI. Project scans your social media posts and makes a digital view. She never did crack it. I think she would have. Given more time. But she used Lenore as a beta test. Made this Lenore bot a little bit ago.
Yep.
I'm sorry.
I called that.
You're right. You are a queen. You're a goddess. And you're gonna live forever. What did you do?
I thought you were just gonna win.
I sent her off like a queen. I bet I still could have sold it.
Hey, Madeline.
He seems
like the voice of a thousand waters, and the deep and dank tarn at my feet closed sullen and silently over the fragments of the House of Usher.
It did fall.
It pulled other things down into the earth with it. My case for one, pointless now. I put him to retirement, and I went home. Juno inherited everything.
Okay.
And she completely dissolved it.
Good.
Fortunato Pharmaceuticals was shuttered, stripped for parts, repurposed into the Phoenix Foundation. Every dollar went for rehabilitation programs, addiction and recovery research, and she weaned herself off Ligadone completely.
It's a horrible outfit, though.
Arthur Kim was arrested a few weeks later after Camille's former assistants turned over a mountain of files to the police.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. He had his chance.
He surrendered himself at the courtroom and didn't utter a word in his defense. He remains the only conviction from the Fortunato Pharmaceutical case. And he will.
Now our thoughts thou shalt not banish. Now our visions dare to vanish. From thy spirit shall they pass no more, like dewdrop from the grass.
Nevermore.
breeze, the breath of God is still, and the mist upon the hill, shadowy, shadowy, yet unbroken, is a symbol and a token. How it hangs upon the trees, a mystery of mysteries.
I thought for sure the last word would have been nevermore, which honestly would have been absolutely perfect. Like I said, she was the angel of death. She was Crowley from Supernatural. There was obviously a social commentary with this that, you know, kind of, like it was kind of going after pharmaceutical companies and talking about how people get addicted to their drugs while they make millions and billions off of it. So that was an interesting way to do that, because, you know, people definitely have made money at the expense and lives of others with drugs. We're not gonna get into anything political here, but yeah. I said that last word should have been nevermore, and it could have been whispered, you know, like when the screen went black, you could have heard nevermore or something like that, you know, just kind of like a whispered, eerie type thing. I don't know, I think that should have been the last word, maybe, because I was kind of expecting it, so I wasn't totally paying attention to what she was saying there, because I kept expecting there to be nevermore again. I'm a little disappointed in that ending, but, well, you know, she mentioned Juno, that Juno went ahead, because I was asking about Juno, but what about Maureen? And she said that she recovers, I guess, and, you know, because she was telling Lenore what was going to happen. So I guess Juno and Maury were saved because they were spouses and they weren't actually blood. But then you think about someone like Bill for Bilt, what happened with him? What happened with Leo's boyfriend? Yeah. Be interesting to find out about them. That was pretty good. I'm glad that I went ahead and watched it. I hope you enjoyed my cat hopping up there during it. And it's funny because it's called A Midnight Dreary, and it's dreary out today. Obviously, it's not midnight, but it's cold and rainy, not too cold, it's in the 60s, but it's rainy and dreary, so it kind of feels like perfect weather to be finishing up The Fall of the House of Usher and finishing up one of Poe's works, too. So, I saw an article, which I made sure to not read, that said, you know, like, it was asking, like, who Verna is. Well, agent of death, etc. Because the fact that she was there with everything is a sign. Now, of course, I can go read the article. But I told myself, don't. Make sure you don't do any of that so that everything will be a surprise. But what are your thoughts? Let me know down in the comments if you enjoyed this, if you didn't, if you wanted a different ending, if you wanted the final word to be nevermore. You know, let's talk, have a conversation. I thank you so much for joining me for my reactions to all 8 episodes of The Fall of the House of Usher. Follow me on Instagram and TikTok, and if you enjoyed this reaction, hit the like button, subscribe for more content. If you're watching this on YouTube, please hit the notification bell to be alerted of future reacts. Link to buy me a coffee is in the description, $5. I'd love to give you a shout out and say, hey, yo, Jane Doe, thank you so much. I'd love to be able to do that. Also, if you are looking for an editor for your own YouTube channel or for other reasons, please click on the other link in the description and that will take you to my editor, Captain Factory. She would be more than happy to talk to you about working and collaborating together. She's awesome. She does the intro, outro, puts up the picture in picture, adds the music and everything. I just sit here and react to whatever's going on screen. So she deserves all the credit, all the kudos to her. Thank you for joining me. As I was filming this in October, I'm going to say Happy Halloween, even though this might go up when it's not Halloween. I'm still going to say Happy Halloween because, as you can see, it's October. Happy whatever day of the year this is that this goes up. Maybe this will go up in October of 2024, or it might go up sooner. I don't know, but you will be seeing this probably in 2024. Could be 2025, depending on how my schedule goes. But I thank you for joining me. I hope you enjoyed it. Again, let's talk down in the comments about anything now regarding the series, regarding Mike Flanagan. If we are going to talk about other Mike Flanagan works, let's try to limit it, if we can, to House of Usher and Midnight Mass, as those are the two that I have seen. I thank you so much. I keep saying that. I really enjoyed The Fall of the House of Usher. Glad I did it. Now I might have to pull out one of Poe's books and reread some of his info. Thank you so much, Mike Flanagan. I'll see you for my next episode, my next video.